Robbie Wong here. We're going to play some Historic Best of 3 against DM Hunter. We're playing Gruul Aggro. Alright, that works. Oh, we're going to be on the draw. Good way to start the day. Losing the die roll. No red mana. Only one mana. I kind of wish we could have kept the first hand. But this five is better than a random four. Okay. Let's go Pelt Collector. And next turn we can go DTE Ooze. No blocks. Take Brawler to turn that into a 3-3. So we drop these two idiots and hope for some Gruul off. Oh, really? Yeah, sure. I think I'm supposed to pass, so that way I can turn this into a 4-4 and start swinging in. Plus I don't have red mana for this. So next turn we'll drop these two idiots. We might take some damage here. It's just when it attacks. Swing with Galia again. Spells I can't cast. I think we need to hold back now. We're losing this race. I don't think they're gonna attack, but we do have some good blocks. All right, so we're gonna. This does not feel like Embercleave. Otherwise, they would have just swung with everybody. Too bad. Ah, let's go to game two. This is pretty far behind. Okay, so what are removal spells? thinking their stuff seems fun. Wait, no, I want BT. Let's take out the stuff that probably is gonna get stuck on the ground and really rely on removal. Yeah, all right, let's do it. No one mana play. Get this in untapped. The next turn is BTE, Voltaic Brawler. Next turn is Swing with Ghoul. It's a pretty aggressive start. I like it. Swing for 6 next turn. Next turn, Gruul Spellbreaker. If nothing dies, then we get to Embercleave the turn after that. Let's see what 2 drops they drew. Looks like they drew removal spells. They'll shoot the Voltaic Brawler. They should wait for me to pay energy. I think next turn is Elf Abraid. Definitely. Well, actually, now I can just Ember Cleave. Embercleave creature against. Oh no! First try. I forgot about that. That's alright. This is out of Abraid and Bone Crusher range, so they need Lava Coil or pair it with a Pelt Collector block or something. So if they give this +3/+3, 7/7. And if I just attack normally and use the Abraid to kill something, then the Gruul Spellbreaker lives. Gotta do this one. Take 2 damage. Totally worth it though. Ow. Got big fast. Alright. So now we've got these 2 idiots. This has trample now. So they could go land Embercleave, but I live at 5. Okay. Embercleave, not a part of it. Alright, so now we run back the +3/+3 play. I was gonna say. You don't want to attack. Well, that seems tasty. If I attack with this, they'll block with all. Yeah. And if they eat these, then this is gonna deal more damage, yeah. Thank you. another one, and you don't have a Fabled Passage, so you can't beat me out of that. Oh, wait. No, that dies. Little sloppy on my part. the double strike, first strike really got me. Alright, we still won. Alright, do your math properly, Wong. Alright, I think I'm happy with the way that went. Let's just run it back. Doom Hunter. Doom. One land makes this hand go nuts, and then we another land after that, and we have. Okay, Discipline Mulligan. Let's do it like this. I don't want to be greedy and do the land. And then Scavenging Ooze is definitely one of the mirror breakers, and I want removal, so I'll take the expensive card out. But then if I'm taking the expensive card out, I should just take a land out. Now let's cast our spells. Mull to 5. Hate to see it. And we get to kill one of their cards with half of a card. No 2-drop. Okay. Currently of the opinion that you save Scavenging Ooze for the end, so that way you can get some value out of it. So plus 1. Plus if you wait, you throw it out of removal spell range. This is good, this is good. So what? This is. We must have just drawn that into another 2-drop? Okay, so now is actually a good time to plant an ooze because it'll live, but then I also want to just start to get damage in. So let's take out the blocker. I suppose I could also just attack and see if he blocks. Okay, next turn we'll have a lot of mana to pump into ooze. Hopefully they tap up for something dumb and they can't. They won't be able to take an ooze out. Alright, that definitely feels like no, I want my green mana to use on ooze. So if they're gonna collect a company, and if they have a removal spell, we'll be able to pump this out of range. Let's attempt to pass a turn and see what. No thanks. Sack that. And then they'll fire off their collective company and then we'll get to eat 3 things. Let's eat out of my bin. Power worth of stuff for 4 mana at instant speed. Could be 7 power. Ooh, and Questing Beast. Alright, we gotta get hit for a turn here. Take 9. Okay, so we know we want this. Battle stop, questing beast. Now the question is, do I want to shock this in? And I think the answer is no. I might need that 2 life. And this'll... I can still Bone Crusher. Like, elf plus Bone Crusher equals Pelt Collector dies. Bone Crusher will block Questing Beast, and then okay. Yeah, they're out of cards, right? Alright. I'm gonna be sad if there's a... See if they block with Pelt Collector. They do? Okay, so then this stops Questing Beast, and I'm gonna eat now before they get an ooze to compete with mine. Now it's whomever draws an Embercleave. 1-1, check. There's 3 creatures there. Let's see, I want the life. So if I attack with this, and they block, I'm happy. And then if they don't block, they take 4, but then they're swinging back. I think... Feels like Coco. I bet it's removal spell or land to appear mysterious. Yeah, it's just whoever draws Embercleave at this point. Or it's another questing beast. Thanks for the 2 life. I think I'm gonna start. We win. Hooray! And what I was gonna say is, like, it might be worth poking them with the Ramadan Ruins. 12. Alright. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. three times.